In celebration of our diocese's 150th anniversary, Christine arranged for different concerts throughout the year. There was one in July with Don Fellows, combined with our awarding of diocesan honors. And then in October, around the time of the 70th anniversary of this cathedral building, Dominic Fiacco played and presented a great program. And while she was planning all this for us, I said, maybe people would want to hear our own organist and music director do something for us. She said, really? I said, yes, really. And so she put together this lovely program for us this afternoon. So this first Sunday of Advent, we're happy to have Christine Bookman present to us this wonderful program to help us pray, relax, reflect on all of God's gifts to us. So thank you, Christine. And everyone also is invited to join us in the Brejana Hall afterwards for a reception. Thank you.
piece, the next piece I'm going to play, is by Franz Liszt. A lot of people don't know that he actually had a choice to make as a youngster. He wanted to become a priest, and his mother convinced him that he needed to be instead of concert pianist. And so he became a concert pianist and then took minor orders after that. And he wrote a good deal of sacred music. His idea was that he wanted to transform the music of the Catholic Church. That was his big goal. And so when I learned this piece, I said, what happened? And my friend Mark said, well, have you heard the rest of it? It's really not very good. So anyway, he was a pianist, and so that's what he could do. So this is his tribute to St. Dorothy, who's the patron saint of gardeners. And we'll have that. Pieces are by Mendelssohn. Okay, so everyone has heard of Felix Mendelssohn. How many people have heard of Fanny Mendelssohn? Nobody? Fanny Mendelssohn was Felix's older sister, and she received the same musical training he did, only she was not allowed to become a professional musician. She married this really cool guy, William Hensel. He was a painter, and he would leave manuscript on her piano for her to fill during the day. And she hosted these wonderful concerts at the Mendelssohn home. She came from a banking family, and so everybody who was famous on tour, you know, would come, and sometimes they'd have 300 people at these little Sunday afternoon salons, they called them. And so she knew all the famous musicians, and they all knew her, and but she wasn't allowed to publish. But one of my favorite stories is, of course, Mendelssohn was from Germany, and so was Prince Albert. So Mendelssohn went to England, and you know, he was rifling through Queen Victoria's music, and she was gonna sing something with him, and he came across his Opus 8, and she said, oh yeah, I wanna sing Italienne, and you'll play for me. I really love that one. And at the end, Felix had to tell her, I'm sorry, that was written by my sister, not me. So, So we're going to hear two pieces by composed by Fanny Mendelssohn, one from the beginning of her life, and or the beginning of her composing career, really modeled after Bach. You'll be able to tell because of all the diminished chords and the chromatics in it. And then a much more lyrical song without words style that her brother became famous for at the end of her life. Okay.
Thank you.
my last three pieces for piano, this is an interesting story. I went to a workshop online given by one of the Korean professors about the Louise Ferranc etudes. We talk a lot about women composers, obviously, in the modern world, but it's really interesting that some of the etudes, or some of the women in this time period, in the Romantic time period, wrote etudes, especially in France. So I originally took this training about Louise Ferranc Opus 50, and I said, oh, that's great, I'm gonna use them with my students, and I got started. And then through social media, I met this this conductor, this female conductor, Eva Meitner, who's in Germany. And she was starting to work, she had just done all Opus 50, so it's all on YouTube. And she said, well, that was so great, I'm gonna start on Opus 42. And I said, oh, that's great, I wanna do Opus 42 as well. And she said, well, why don't we do them together? And about a week later, I realized she probably wants me to upload a video. So I started working on Opus 42. And along the way, I found out about Marie Bagot, who was a little bit earlier in France, but along the way, she taught the Mendelssohns at one point. So it was kind of cool. So three little etudes, and then I'll go upstairs, okay?
Thank you.
Thank you. So I'm going to head upstairs, and if you'll give me a few moments to catch my breath after I get there, I'll get set up on the organ and we'll continue. Feel free to move around and chat if you'd like. Thank you. Okay. I think I'm ready. So my first piece is also written by Fanny Mendelssohn. Fanny Mendelssohn, this is the first organ piece she wrote. She only wrote two organ pieces, and they were both performed at her wedding. This one she wrote for the professional, or for the processional, rather. And I think she got a little carried away, because you'll notice that it's way too long for any aisle that I've ever seen brides go down. But it's wonderful nonetheless. And the second one, she ended up writing because Felix was supposed to write the recessional. And he was in a carriage accident and wasn't able to deliver the music. And so she, the night before, among guests and everyone at the house, sat down with her paper and wrote, composed the recessional for her wedding the next day. I haven't had time to learn that one yet, but this is the first, the processional.
Thank you.
So I thought Advent was the perfect time to explore some of the beautiful sounds on this organ. So I'm doing a string of Advent tunes, and hopefully this will give you a good idea of the contrast and variations we can have. So I'm starting with The King Shall Come and the Melis Mata Variations, which a shout out to my Wadham Singers friends. Remember Christians All. Did we have that playing in our heads every Advent? And then two Noels, but I'll talk to you about them in a minute.
Thank you.
The next two pieces will be two French Noels. The first by César Franck, this is the 200th anniversary of his birth, and so there's a bunch of César Franck celebrations this year. And then the second one by a friend of his, who I have to look at the name because I will get it wrong. Does anybody know French? Charles Alexis Chauvet, who was very well known, as you can read in your program notes. So we'll have those two Noels. Thank you very much. Before I wrap things up today, I would like to thank everyone for coming. Thanks, friends and loved ones, for all your support and your love. And thank you, Father Morgan, for supporting my ideas and for being the best boss ever. So today I will end with, as appropriate, Hail Holy Queen. This is an arrangement by Paul Fei. You can see him on YouTube. Well, he puts out a new video, I think, every couple of days or something like that. He's really young. Today's his birthday. He's 24, and he's studying sacred music and organ at the Specialist University in Germany. So we look forward to wonderful things from him, and I hope you enjoy Hail Holy Queen.
Thank you. Thank you.